Good afternoon, guys. This is Ankur here, and I welcome you all to my YouTube channel, Technical Analysis, The Invest View. So I thought that from this weekend onwards, I'm going to start a technical portion and a few examples with some technical lessons for you guys, so that we can learn the technical gradually. We can increase our foresight, how to read the chart, and let's start this session, this weekend session, the very first episode, where we're going to start learning technicals. And today's topic would be descending patterns and volume. Correct? Descending patterns and volume. And I'll share that what I spotted on two stocks. And one stock would be homework for you. And you can comment in the below in the section that what you spotted based after once while we discuss everything in today's episode. So let's start it quickly, and I'm going to share few notes with you on descending channel and volume, and let's have a look at the few key points what we have to look on a descending channels along with the volume, and we'll see those two stocks the third stock will be the homework for you, and I'll share you a few key points, not only the write-up but also the volume chart and the delivery chart, which is available on the NSC website. So starting with the first point, listen it very carefully. You can take a screenshot also if you want. So I'm going to read a first point for you, that if on a descending channel, stock's volume starts increasing on a green candle and decreasing on a red candle, it means that it is going to turn bullish. It means that if a stock is falling, correct, in a descending channel, from top it is coming down, it is making lower highs, and on a red candles, a significant red candles, where is a 2%, 3% kind of a move on those particular day, if the volume is less, and during that fall, whenever there is a green candle occurring and the green candle volume is comparatively higher than the previous 2 to 3 days volume, then it is a earlier signal that it may turn out to be bullish. The second important point is, in a descending channel pattern, the volume should decrease with the formation of a pattern. The key factor is that the volume should be high on the breakouts and should remain high even after the breakout for few candles. The third important point is, volume alone does not tell you the whole story. Price also does not tell you the whole story, but together they can tell you a great exciting story. So alone volume, you cannot guess what is going to be happen in the chart next, and not with respect to the price action alone you can guess. So you need to have a combination of both. Why? I'll explain you later. To determine if the rally is real, up days should be accompanied by increased volume, whereas down days should be on a lower overall on the market volume. Fifth point, about volume, one thing should be kept in mind before the gap, before any gap, right? There are four types of gap: runaway gap, breakaway gap, common gap, exhaustion gap. These are different gaps. I will discuss those gap pattern also maybe next weekend. So on the gap, volume should be comparatively low. On the day of the gap, it should be high. And the volume should remain higher than the average of 2 to 3 days with increased price, so that price can safely reach further ahead. So this is the way to trade the gap. Correct? Sometimes we say that it may come and fill the gap. Gaps are not reliable. To trade the gap, this is the key point for us. Sixth point. If a green candle comes and its volume is more than the previous red candle, please remain invested. When the day's candle is red and its volume is more than the previous green candle, then that is an early signal to take an exit if you are on an intraday or on a swing trade. Do not trade channels by lagging indicator like moving averages. At times, few indicators are overrated. Correct? So when a price is moving in a particular channel where there's a particular support and resistance, and it is taking that resistance and support and kept on moving within the channel, Do not over rely on moving averages. Always trade these channels with the help of oscillator like RSI, which is the leading indicator. Now in RSI, we'll discuss step-by-step divergence, reversals, right? So those things also we'll have in our episodes. So it is a long chain which I'm planning only on the weekends. A lagging indicator follows price, whereas the leading indicator leads the price. That means in a simple language that the price will follow a leading indicator like RSI. So it would be better technical tool for showing what price is going to do when it is in the channel. Correct? Now, very important point, especially for the weekend shortlisting. You can choose the direction of the stock from monthly chart if it is not visible on a weekly chart. Second, in continuation, you can consider the price point from the weekly chart for swing trades. And in continuation, the last point would be observe daily charts for patterns and volumes. Correct? Never ever rush when the stock is falling towards your support level. Never rush when the stock is falling towards your support level. Let it stop and move up. Let it test it. Correct? So do not anticipate if you have drawn a earlier horizontal line or earlier channel. Correct? That yes, it is going to come here. It is falling and it is going to take a U-turn. Let that day go. Let, as I always say, when I make my videos on the night for next day, that closing above the resistance and closing below the support is more important to have a bearish and a bullish view. Correct? So let it test. Let it give you the signal. The latest example was Reliance, that I have been saying that do not short until and unless it closes below 1960. Keep 1960 as a stop loss, or the day it closes below 1960, that is the way to exit and switch the trade. And you see what happened yesterday, it went up to 5%. Correct? This is the point which is taken on a live or on a latest one of the suggestions which I give you. A very important point: in a descending channel pattern, the volume should decrease with the formation of pattern. When we are talking about the reversals, so in a descending channel pattern, the volume should decrease with the formation of pattern. The key factor is that the volume should be high on breakouts and should remain high even after the breakout for few candles. Correct? That few candle could be a 2 to 5 day average. That is what I follow. Volume at the breakout should be more than the volume of previous candles. Very, very, very important point, where the volume plays most important role. Sometimes you will find that you can't draw a proper channel on a daily chart, whether it is a descending or ascending. Today we are talking pertaining to descending. So way to solve this problem is go to weekly chart or monthly chart and draw the channel and duplicate on a daily chart and wait for candles on a daily chart to go and test those trend lines. And last but not the least, we need to have at least 100 candle data for a reliability. That is my simple protocol. Correct? So these are the key notes with respect to the descending channel and the volume, how to match the price action and volume on a descending channel. Now let me give you two quick examples. Let me show you what I spotted and one stock which I tweeted and took a huge rally, and one is something very, very latest I discussed with you guys day before yesterday, and one stock will be homework for you guys, so you can drop your comments and see what you have noticed on that stock. So the first stock would be Hero MotoCorp. If you'd have remember, I think on Thursday or maybe perhaps on Wednesday, I have recorded a detailed analysis on Hero MotoCorp. Now what we have studied and what I'm going to show you, I will relate that. See, this is the descending channel, right? The price is dropping from here. I think it is visible to you guys. The price is dropping. It is making higher low. Correct. It was on an ascending channel. Then the price started dropping. Correct. Now what happened? It took the support and made another pattern called rounding bottom pattern. Correct. When it was on a descending channel and then it started making a rounding bottom pattern. So I would have taken a horizontal line example from the past data like this, but I would not anticipate that yes, it will take the support so that I'll make a BTST call on that. No, I would wait for a conclusive evidence that yes, it made a pattern. Correct. Now, one key point. Look at this candle, the bottom where it tested the horizontal line. Correct. If I keep a vertical bar on that particular candle, I can show you that there is a volume of 1.437 million, more than 1 million volume. But on a day before, on a very small candle, the volume was 740K. Correct. So close to 3 lakh trade shares were traded. The volume was more than the previous red candle, and significantly, as I have mentioned, strong intersection base. It means this channel and the bottom of the rounding bottom, and the volume was significantly high. See, this is the volume, and it is more than the average volume of past few days, and that was the stock which took the support. And you can see the low made of that particular day was 2750, and it rallied all the way up to 3009. Correct. So this is the good interpretation of mixing the volume with the patterns, right? No need not to anticipate. Let that day go. No worries, right? You can buy on a higher, but you need to have few confirmations before you make any trade. Don't anticipate. Let the price action and volume and the patterns put together give you the confirmation. Correct. Now I would like to take you to a Excel sheet I have prepared for Hero MotoCorp. This is the only 3 months data, not more than that. This is just a 3 month data where I have selected few points: dates, close price, total traded quantity, number of trades, deliverable quantity, and percentage delivery quantity to traded share. Now, if you see in this 3 months data, which is roughly 58 trading sessions, the average volume of those 58 trading sessions were 9.59 lakhs. Overall, from day zero to day, matlab, if we have taken the 3 months data, roughly it is coming to 58 trading sessions. So put together of all those 58 trading sessions, the average volume is 9.59 lakhs. Correct. So what is the average volume of a lower than this? Correct. This is the average volume of 58 days. So there were few trading sessions where the volume was significant. Correct. If you take out that for a minute, so there were 39 trading sessions. Correct. Where the normal trading is happening, normal trading, right? So the normal average volume in Hero MotoCorp is 7.3 lakhs. Correct. But there are few days where the volume is good, significant. Correct. In this 19 trading sessions, avoid the result days. Correct. So those 19 trading sessions where the volume was significant, the average volume of that significant trading days were 14.28 lakhs. Now, if you compare the normal course, correct, the normal course, the average, the difference between the exceptional volumes versus the normal volume is 50%. 50%, it means double. Correct. So this is the example for you with respect to Hero MotoCorp's. Hereafter, whenever you guys see volume happening in Hero MotoCorp more than 1 million, close to 14 lakh, 13 lakh, 12 lakh, sub like that. And if there is a bottom or a top happening, and if it is taking a support of a long-term moving average after ascending or a descending or any horizontal volume pattern or any kind of a pattern which you guys believe, whether that's a triangle pattern, there's a W, that is M, there's a number of patterns, like number of patterns, like head and shoulder neckline breakout, inverted head and shoulder neckline breakout. I mean, I can keep on seeing the 50 chart patterns likewise. So anywhere, if you see a support or a resistance with this kind of a volume, 14.28 lakhs, or very, very, very important point, during the day when you see a volume crossing 9.59 lakhs, this price, this volume, I mean, when you see there is a breakout happening, the Hero Motocorp was in a descending channel, it took the support, now it started coming upwards, and it is crossing 7.3 lakhs, first confirmation of the breakout. If it is crossing 9.59 lakhs, second confirmation of the breakout, day volume is closing around 13 to 14 lakhs, carry the BTST. That is how you have to match your descending channel reversal with the volume and the pattern. Correct? So that was the reason to share the Hero Motocorp. So the descending channel, rounding bottom, the bottom took the support and it showed a higher volume than the previous average days. Correct? The average volume of previous days, and this was, you see, if I keep a bar like this, so 709, 683, 859, 557 likewise. And here on the breakout, on the reversal, when it took support, it was more than 1 million. So that is the confirmation. Now here it is relying on the intersection. So the previous day volume was 1 million. So guys, if it crossed 1 million during the day, right, or ended up the breakout close above this with the higher volumes around 14 lakh, 12 lakh, 13 lakhs, you can play for 3239 as discussed on that particular day. Another stock would like to discuss with you, you can go to my Twitter channel. The ID is Ankur280986. On 20th of October 2020, correct? I have tweeted that Bharti Airtel formed a bullish falling wedge pattern closing above 410 can be a trend reversal. Now, which pattern you can observe here? The pattern is rounding top pattern. Correct? Rounding top pattern. Let me take you to the Bharti Airtel chart. Correct? Now, on this rounding top pattern, this is the neckline. Correct? Perhaps this is the neckline. Now, what happened? The neckline formed a falling wedge pattern, which is a bullish reversal pattern. Correct? Which is a bullish reversal pattern. And similarly, when it gave a breakout of this bullish reversal pattern, correct, then the day before the volume was 16.92 million, and on the next day when it made a green candle with a breakout closing above the falling wedge pattern, the volume was 25, and see the magic, the low was 396 and it went all the way to 623. Imagine the amount of money you can make, right? Even if you make 50% of the rally, even if you make 25% of the rally, just imagine that. Correct? The lot size is, I think, more than 1800, if I'm not wrong. So this is a yet another example on a reversal, on a very strong rising wedge pattern, falling wedge pattern on the neckline of a rounding top, and it gave the breakout, and you see the volume started increasing than the average, and it remained 25 lakh, 23 lakh, 26 lakh, correct? And it started rising upwards, and then you can take the, then you can consider other things like a moving average and the breakout and the retesting. That's a separate thing which we'll discuss in coming days. Correct?